For this is a remarkable mineral. It is made up of tiny but extremely strong and flexible fibers. It was natural that the scientists would turn to asbestos. Being stone, asbestos will not burn.
This is asbestos, once known as this magical mineral that disrupted many industries like construction, automobile, power, and chemical industries, to being known today as the most hazardous naturally occurring mineral. Asbestos has excellent fireproofing properties, and it is lightweight with high strength and durability. It was commonly used in various products and materials, including insulation, roofing, flooring, textiles, and more. And because it is easily accessible and cheap to process, it didn't take long before it became a very well-known product in the construction industry. But there is a dark side to asbestos. Asbestos is a hazardous product. It is the number one cause of work-related deaths in the world. Approximately 90,000 people die from asbestos-related diseases globally each year. These are only the recorded cases, as industry-related deaths are very hard to track. So the question is, why we used asbestos in the first place, and why it continues to be used? This is a story of innovation, but also a story of corruption and greed. This is how asbestos almost revolutionized the construction industry.
The actual use of this material on homes over the years is the final convincing proof. Combined with Portland cement, these fibers act as a reinforcing agent.
The miracle mineral was actually one of the greatest industrial hazards ever known.
If you smoke a lot, I suggest that you take the Kent carton test and just see for yourself what a difference.
Hi, Joseph here, and I'll have a quick disclaimer for you. This video is for educational purposes only, and it's not a substitute for professional advice. I am not a health expert, and I'm only highlighting the history and the dangers of asbestos. And I would highly recommend that you would seek professional advice if you come in contact with asbestos or if you have very specific questions. Now that's out of the way, let's get back to the video.
The term asbestos refers to six fibrous minerals that occur naturally throughout the world. Chrysotile accounts for approximately 95% of asbestos used around the world. The danger of asbestos lies in its fibrous nature. If disturbed, it releases microscopic fibers into the air, which commonly happens during the manufacturing and handling of asbestos. These fibers can be inhaled or ingested into the body. Those microscopic fibers, like needles, stain the lungs and other parts of the body and cause serious health issues over time, such as mesothelioma, lung cancer, and asbestosis, and many other respiratory diseases. Early evidence of asbestos uses dated back to the ancient Egyptians. The manufacturing of asbestos on mass scale started in the late 1800s. Asbestos resistant to chemical heat, water, and electricity. Its extreme durability made it an excellent insulator for the steam engines, turbines, boilers, and electrical generators that powered the Industrial Revolution. The malleable properties of asbestos made it an important building, binding, and strengthening material. As the mining and manufacturing of asbestos exploded, so did dangerous health effects on those who mined and refined the mineral, as well as those who worked with it. The asbestos industry was run by shady corporations that made a huge profit by selling asbestos products. While asbestos workers were dying in those factories, many asbestos product manufacturers knew early that working with the mineral caused harmful health effects. Cases of damage, lung diseases, and lung cancer were very common among asbestos workers. Asbestos is not considered dangerous when it's left undisturbed. When asbestos is disturbed, asbestos fibers can be released into the air. Work conditions were very dusty, as turning asbestos into different products required breaking and disturbing this mineral, which released those microfibers into the air, which the workers inhaled. Those fiber-like needles became trapped into the lungs and damaged them over time, scarring lung tissues and leading to shortness of breath and cough, and eventually leading to serious diseases such as mesothelioma, lung cancer, asbestosis, and other respiratory diseases. Those effects were well cited in the mid-19th century. In 1906, the first documented death of an asbestos worker from the same health issues was recorded. The autopsy revealed large amounts of asbestos fibers into the lungs. During that time, reports of similar cases were recorded from other factories from around the world. The report suggested that asbestos workers were dying and naturally young. As early as 1908, insurance companies in the US and Canada began decreasing coverage and benefits while increasing premiums for workers employed in the asbestos industry. Eventually, they stopped selling life insurance to workers who worked in those factories. Despite consistent health warnings, asbestos mining and manufacturing was an engine that could not be stopped. In 1910, world production exceeded 109,000 metric tons, more than three times the total in 1900. The US quickly became the world leader in asbestos usage. Even in World War II, production increased to 60%, up from 37% in 1937. This incredible success and demand for asbestos products made those corporations incredibly shady toward the danger of asbestos. Heavy use of asbestos by the US military eventually led to high rates of mesothelioma in veterans. US consumption of asbestos peaked in 1973 at 804,000 tons. In 1977, asbestos ore production reached 4.8 million metric tons. The huge profit from producing asbestos products made those corporations very powerful and corrupt. They tried to settle asbestos-related deaths quietly. Admitting the risk of dealing and inhaling asbestos meant losing consumer faith in the product and would bring the industry to a halt. Asbestos companies never ran any awareness campaigns to show how hazardous asbestos was and reverted to denying any correlations between those deaths and the hazardous nature of asbestos throughout the mid-1900s. In fact, they did quite the opposite by running ad campaigns to promote asbestos-related products.
And so, we suggest you consider this material for the walls of your home. Designed to last a lifetime. A trouble-free lifetime. And so, asbestos cement took its place with other sidewall materials. Wood, brick, stucco, and stone. But its use is not confined to new construction.
To Kent, change to Kent. With the micronite filter.
You'll find that Kent's micronite filter gives you high filtration. High filtration to help you keep your smoking moderate.
Stopping the industry could bring down millions and millions of dollars in profits every year. Asbestos had almost endless uses. It is a good insulator and conductor. Its fireproofing ability made it an excellent material in homes, building, and other house items. At some point, it was in almost everything. We had asbestos cement, asbestos insulation, asbestos roofing, flooring, textile clutches, and braking pads for automotives and airplanes. We had asbestos millboards, fireproofing sprays and paints, and the list goes on. We used so much of asbestos in the past between 1930 to 1990 that it can still be found in old buildings. The thing about asbestos is that it's difficult to identify after installation unless lab tested. Many houses and buildings built in the previous century most likely contain asbestos. If those buildings are left undisturbed, people who live in those buildings are safe. When those buildings are renovated, it can pose a risk of construction workers being exposed to asbestos. The truth was that people who worked in construction, manufacturing, and other blue-collar industries were at most risk of asbestos exposure. People who lived with an asbestos worker were also at risk of secondary exposure from washing or getting in contact with their clothes. However, by the late 1970s, a dramatic decline began in the use of asbestos throughout the industrialized nations. The public was beginning to understand the connection between asbestos exposure and lung diseases. Mining in the US spiked in the 1960s and 1970s. The last active asbestos mine in the US closed in 2002. Organized labor and trade unions were demanding safer and healthier working conditions and liability claims against major asbestos manufacturers, which caused many of those asbestos factories to declare bankruptcy to relieve themselves from any financial burdens. By 2003, New environmental regulations and consumer demand helped push for full or partial ban on the use of asbestos in 17 countries. In 2005, asbestos was banned throughout the European Union. Yet in recent years, many of the world's emerging economies have embraced the use of asbestos as much as developing nations did for much of the previous century, keeping the asbestos industry moving. Around 3,000 Americans are diagnosed with mesothelioma every year. Asbestos exposure causes at least 90% of all mesothelioma cases. From 1999 to 2010, approximately 6,300 Americans lost their lives to asbestosis. Out of all the conditions, asbestos-related lung cancer claimed the most lives, followed by mesothelioma. So the question is, do we still use asbestos today? Asbestos has been banned in more than 60 countries, but not in the US. Asbestos is still manufactured and used around the world. Russia is the world's largest producer of asbestos, with an annual production of around 700,000 metric tons. The good thing is that the public awareness of the danger of asbestos is well known in the construction industry. If it is found in old buildings, it can be removed by professionals to eliminate the risk of exposure to this product. Even with this amount of control, an estimated 125 million people worldwide remain at risk of occupational exposure to asbestos. Around 1.3 million US workers in construction and general industry are at risk of exposure today. As asbestos was banned and phased out in many countries, there has been growing demand for safer alternatives. Today, there are many alternatives to asbestos. In the end, the question remains, if corporations knew the danger of this mineral, why did they use it and why do they still use it? A 2008 study reported that for every 20 tons of asbestos produced and consumed, a person dies of an asbestos-related disease somewhere in the world. Asbestos declined from 4.8 million metric ton in 1977 to 1.3 million metric ton today. This is still around 65,000 people dying from asbestos every year. Thanks for watching and stay safe. Subscribe if you like this type of content, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers!